Jake, a curious and adventurous teenage boy, always sought thrills in the most unconventional ways. One evening, while browsing the internet, he stumbled upon a mysterious forum that claimed to host a game of truth on the dark web. Intrigued by the dark and forbidden allure, he decided to participate in the game. Jake followed the instructions and logged into the Game of Truth forum, which was nothing like he had seen before. It was filled with unknown symbols that surrounded a chat box. Hesitant but enticed, he entered the chat box and announced his presence. Almost instantly, the chat box exploded with messages from faceless entities. They welcomed him, urging him to play the game of truth. "Ask any question, and it shall be answered truthfully," one message read. Intrigued yet cautious, Jake hesitated before typing, "What is the meaning of life?" The response he received sent shivers down his spine. To discover the unknown and embrace the darkness within. For every truth Jake sought, he had to offer a truth in return. They warned that any lies would be revealed, and deceit would be met with severe consequences. With a gulp of apprehension, he agreed, unsure of what dark secrets he might have to reveal. The game began with simple questions related to his favorite color, childhood memories and dreams. But as the night wore on, the questions delved deeper into Jake's darkest fears and desires. A question appeared. "What is your deepest regret?" the chatbot demanded. Jake hesitated, contemplating whether to share the secret he had kept hidden for years or to continue hiding it within. Finally, he confessed, "I let my best friend die, and I didn't help him, and I covered up the truth." The chat box responded with a chilling acknowledgement of his truth. "That is the truth." The chatbot went silent, and a name illuminated on his screen. It was his friend's name, Jason, who had passed away in a tragic incident years ago. Jake's heart pounded as he stared at his friend's name on his computer screen. Suddenly, his friend's face appeared on the screen, followed by images of Jason's lifeless body, reminding him that he was partly responsible for his friend's death. Jake frantically tried to close the browser, but the chat box reappeared each time, displaying more unsettling messages and images, each exposing a truth about the tragic event. His heart raced as the gruesome scenes of the incident flashed on his screen over and over. The guilt that weighed on him intensified. After several attempts of trying to close the browser, he reached down and pulled the plug to his computer out of the electric outlet. The screen went dark and Jake felt a moment of relief. But suddenly, the images reemerged on his screen. Jake jumped away from the desk and backed into a corner of his room. Suddenly, his phone began to ring. Trembling, he retrieved his phone from his bed and glanced at the caller ID. His heart pounded in terror when he saw Jason's name displayed on the screen. Fear and disbelief washed over him. Jason had been dead for years. How could he be calling? With trembling hands, he answered the call, half expecting it to be some twisted prank. "Hello?" Jake whispered, his voice quivering. A haunting silence followed before he heard a faint, ghostly voice on the other end. "Jake, why did you let me go?" Tears welled up in Jake's eyes and his voice choked as he replied, "I'm so sorry, Jason. I tried to help, but it was too late." The voice persisted, sorrowful yet accusatory. "You were my best friend. I thought you would save me, but you let me die." Snapping back to reality, Jake ended the call and threw the phone across the room, causing it to land on the floor on the opposite side of the room. Phone began to ring again. His computer screen illuminated and images of his friend, and the scenes of the tragic incident began erratically flashing on his computer screen. Jake closed his eyes, covered his ears with his hands, and began screaming. "Stop! Stop! I'm sorry. Please stop." Suddenly, the computer screen went dark. His phone stopped ringing. Jake now stood in darkness. Only the sound of his beating heart could be heard. Jake turned on the light in his room and stared at the blank computer screen. Jake vowed never to visit the dark web again, leaving his biggest secret and greatest fear within its darkness.